All right, I'll start you off with an easy question. How did you start your music career?
I started it from school. So I was in school for music, and then I ended up going and doing an undergrad. And during that, I realized that I wanted to be an artist. So during the pandemic, I started releasing music under Kendra Gabrielle and haven't looked back since.
Cool. Did you know at a young age that you'd be doing this, or just something that happened?
No, definitely not at a young age. When I was older, I think around the age of 15, I was like, I'm doing this for sure. No matter what, I'm going to be in music somehow. I didn't quite know whether it would be as an artist or a teacher or what. I just knew I was called to do music.
Okay, that makes sense. And are you the only one in your family that has a musical background?
There Like my family like sings and we all love music, but no one does it professionally. I'm the first one to do it, but definitely a lot of music around the house growing up and lots of choirs and yeah, it's just no one did it professionally and I was like, why not me?
Right. And what would you describe your genre to be?
I would say it's mostly country, like new country, what's currently on trend or like what people consider country pop, but as I grow and evolve, I think I will merge country with like different genres. Like I definitely like what Shania Twain did, and what she spoke about in her documentary, being she wanted to be a rock star, so she brought a little bit of rock influence into country, and I think it's super cool that you can blend genres in this day and age. So for right now, it would be considered country pop, but I wouldn't put it past me that. If you spoke to me next year, I'd be like, oh, it's a little bit of country pop, country rock, and maybe something else.
That makes sense. Do you have any passions besides music?
I love taking photos and like being the photographer, not like being the model. But I enjoy capturing moments and editing and playing with color. I think anything to do with a creative mind, I'd probably be interested in.
That's cool. And do you write your own songs?
I do. The last couple singles that I've released, I've been a co-writer on. And it's really fun to say that this is my story. It's not only my voice, but it's also my thoughts. And people like it. It's something really special.
Right. Do you have a process when you're doing that, writing songs or anything like that, or is it just spiritual free flow and see what happens?
It's definitely a process. I realized I'm the kind of person that needs to talk with my co-writers and really get to like what the point of this song is. Like I can't go in with like this is the title and we're gonna write a song. I kind of like have like a situation, tell them about the situation, and then we write the song. I've never been one of those that it's like, here's a melody and I can put words to it. I wish I was, and I hope one day soon I will get there because that will definitely speed up the process. But that's basically how I've been writing all my songs that have been out so far.
Awesome. And do you suffer from writer's block?
I think every creative does, and I definitely do. I think the biggest thing about writer's block is there are so many thoughts outside, like in the world already, like different songs, right? It's like everything's been done, and writer's block comes from a place of like, how do I make something different that hasn't been said that people will still connect to that's not too different? So, yeah, short answer, yes. Long answer, it's yes, but you learn to overcome it.
That makes sense. Do you have a favorite song that you wrote or like to sing?
My favorite song that I've written is Red. That's my current single, and we can sing "Learn Red." And my favorite song to sing, I love a good challenging song. Right now, one of my favorites to sing is "I Will Always Love You." the Whitney version, and I played it on acoustic guitar.
Oh, really? That's cool.
Yeah, it's super fun, and it's cool to do music that other legends have put out.
Right. And do you have a song that has emotional connection to you that you like to sing, even if it's not your own?
I don't perform it, but I do have a song that's very much connected to me. It's My Heart Will Go On by Celine Dion, and it was my lullaby as a baby. And till this day, I still can sometimes fall asleep to it, or I listen to it while working. It's definitely one of my favorite songs. We have a really long relationship, that song, since birth.
Oh, that's good to hear. And so, are you, do you do singing when you perform or sing? Do you prefer acoustic guitar or just sometimes without or a mix or how do you do that?
I love having my favorite guitar with me. It's almost like a piece of me when I'm on stage. It, more likely than not, if you come out to a show, because I'm an independent artist, and there's not many folk and gigs that you can get when you're just starting out. It's mostly just me and my guitar. So the real Kendra Gabrielle that you get to know is me and my guitar. But I also love just getting to sing and have a band backing me up. So I'm good with either, but I think you get to know me more personally when I play acoustically and sing.
Awesome. And did you have a fallback option in case your music career didn't go as planned?
Yes and no. Like I mentioned, I did go to school for music, so the fallback was music. But honestly, I have a feeling like no matter what, there's going to be a way that I'm going to be doing music somehow. So the fallback is music.
That makes sense. Good answer as well. When was the last time you performed?
The last time, like 2 Fridays ago, Easter weekend, I got to close up a show for the first time with a full band. I've always been like either in the middle or an opener because I'm so new to the scene, but I actually closed the show, and that was like a super cool. And I'm like, oh, I can do this. I can stay up past my bedtime. So a couple weeks ago.
Awesome. And do you do something before the show or after the show, like a ritual or anything like that, or do you just go with the flow?
Well, it's not like a ritual, but I find that more often than not, about 15 minutes before I go on, I will just like stand by myself and really just get like in the zone. It just helps me get focused, like, okay, you're about to go on, like put on, strap on my shoes. I tend to wear 6-inch heels on stage, but I will not be walking around in them before I go on. So about like 10 minutes before, I will put on the shoes and be like, okay, we're gonna go on. And yeah, and then once I'm done, it's like just all smiles and going off that high that you just had an incredible performance.
That makes sense. And what's it like to perform on stage for you? What's the feeling like?
It's home. To me, performing is a very, it's my safe haven. It's where I go to when I'm set, or if I had a bad day, I sing. So the fact that I get to be on stage, even when I'm in a good mood, or whether if it's been a rough day and I get to go and share my stories and share my voice and my talent in front of people, it's just like such a safe place for me. So any stage is like a home.
Awesome, good answer. And since you're somewhat newer to the music scene, and not a whole bunch of people know who you are sometimes when you perform, have you ever noticed that some of the crowd, if they seem uninterested or not paying attention to you? And if you have, does that bother you?
I think for me, I don't let that affect me. I think that even if someone's not listening and you're at a restaurant, you're not the main focus. But I think more often than not that if you sing a song that they like in my particular set list, I have a bunch of obscure songs that you wouldn't expect a country singer to sing. One that people tend to like is I Do Angel by Shaggy by myself, and I do the rap part. I do all three verses, and people tend to turn their heads and be like, oh, she's doing that. Like, you go from singing like 9 to 5, and then you go and sing Angel by Shaggy. That's like quite a difference. And I think when it's their time to find you, they will find you. But it doesn't bother me. I think as long as I get to do what I love, I'm happy.
Awesome, that's a good answer. Do you have a favorite venue or place you've performed at so far?
I think they're all super fun. I think one that I have played the most at is at the Moonshine in Oakville. It's like considered like the Bluebird of Canada, and that's just such a welcoming place. That venue actually does feel like home because I've gotten to know the owner and I've gotten to know like the sound guy who's always there, so I always know like don't gotta worry about how you're gonna sound today. But I would say currently that would probably be my favorite, but I don't have a favorite because all stages are fun to be on.
Awesome. And do you have a dream place that you want to perform at?
I have multiple. Can I say multiple?
Of course.
I would say the Bluebird Cafe would be super cool. The Grand Ole Opry would also be amazing. Like at the Grammys or like the Junos in Canada. I think those would be like some pretty cool stages to play on. Or Boots and Hearts.
I agree completely. Is there anything that you'd do differently or change in your music career, or are you happy with what you've done so far?
I think I'm always learning. Like, I do the best of what I know about the industry and try to follow what you're supposed to do as an artist and stay on top of it. But there are definitely things that I will think of in the future that are probably like you're not supposed to do, but you do it anyway because that's just what would work best for yourself. But that's a really interesting question. I don't know what I would like anything different that I do. It's pretty standard.
Awesome. And do you have any
I will
upcoming
say I
plans?
do everything by myself.
Okay. Do you have
So
any
I
up?
think the one thing different is,
Sorry, go ahead.
sorry.
But
No, I said like the only thing different that I would do is in the future is maybe get a team when
okay.
needed.
Right. That's always a good option to have.
Oh yeah.
Do you have any upcoming plans in your music career?
I do. I have a bunch of shows coming up in the next month and throughout the summer. I made it like a goal for me, and now thinking back on it, it might be too overachieving, but I wanted to play 100 shows this year, so
Holy.
I'm like try to like you know like grow myself to it slowly, but I'm also not putting like that much pressure on me. Like if I don't make it like to 100, if I play like over 50 shows, you're still successful. You played shows, but I do have new music coming out. I have couple videos coming out, and I'm going back into the studio this summer, so a lot of fun things are happening in my little music business going on.
Sounds like fun, and sounds like you're gonna be very, very busy.
Yeah, I love being busy. I think all artists are super busy planning, and we all have to plan so far ahead in time to make sure like we're meeting our deadlines, because one thing that's very famous in our industry is that things get pushed all the
Right.
time. So it's always fun trying to navigate that to be like, how can I plan this so I don't have to push it?
Gotcha, that makes sense. And if you don't mind, we're going to switch the topic so we talk about more about you personally. You're okay with that? Awesome.
All right, let's go for it.
What's your favorite color?
Red.
Why red?
It's just been with me since I was a kid. I think like I was a flower girl. My favorite flower girl dress is red. My prom dress was red. the university that I went to, their colors were red and black. I have a single out that's red. So red has just always been there for me. It's such a bold color. It's very like in your face, and I just like it.
Awesome. What are some of your hobbies?
Music. It's a career and a hobby. I sometimes work out twice a week. I'm an athlete. Work out sometimes. I sometimes read. I think like the basic is like she just does music all the time, like 24/7. I like doing that with friends, I think. As you grow older, you find like everyone's just so busy. So I think like a hobby is just trying to meet up with your friends. That's a skill set in its own right. Yeah, just like honestly, even relaxing, like learning to slow down and not always be so hyper focused on having to work and go according to a certain hustle culture.
Okay, that makes sense. So what does your typical evening look like?
Well, my evenings start pretty late because I usually am teaching until 9 p.m. at night. So my evenings are pretty much taken up. I teach music to anyone and everyone. And that's also, I did tell you I do music like 25/7. And I will usually come home, like eat dinner late. I'm a big like late night eater, and just relax, remove my makeup, and go to bed and watch Netflix. Like that's it. I am like an early bedtime person, so pretty much like after work, I'm like, that's enough for today.
Do you have any favorite shows on Netflix or movies?
Well, like just like favorite all time or like what I'm watching right now.
What you watching right now?
I'm watching Suits. I
Okay.
started it like a month ago and I was like, I'm gonna like do it slowly. I'm gonna like be like normal and watch it normal. And there are 9 seasons. I'm on season 8.
Wow.
And there are like 16 episodes per season, and they're all 40 minutes, and it's like I don't know. I just like I'm a stickler to like one show, but the other show that I really enjoyed was How I Met Your Mother, and now the spinoff with Hilary Duff is super cool as well. So also a big fan of Hilary Duff. Like we all grew up with her.
Right. So what is your most prized possession?
Taylor guitar.
If you could pick one of them,
Definitely.
which one?
Oh, I only have one Taylor guitar, so I would pick that one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It's the guitar that I perform with the most, so it's definitely my prized possession, and it's Kendra sized.
Fun. And what is your greatest accomplishment in your life?
Well, I'm just going to throw it out that I'm not that old. So I'm hoping there will be more accomplishments than what I'm going to say right now. I would say I have a couple that are all like under like the same umbrella. It's just doing music like full time and really getting to do this career and getting my degree in music and getting nominated. After releasing my first country single for Best New Artist at the Mississauga Music Awards last year, that was like super incredible because when it's like just your first single out in the country scene and you get nominated, it's pretty big validation.
Right, that makes sense. What is your favorite memory if you have one?
Favorite memory, like as a child or just in life?
Whichever one would you classify as a favorite? Can be new, old.
My favorite memory, I got to climb the Great Wall of China. That was pretty cool.
Wow.
It was really hot. It's actually easier to climb up than to climb down. Like usually, you know how you can run downstairs? You actually cannot run down the stairs of the Great Wall
Wow.
because they're not even. So like your legs kind of feel like jelly. It's a really funny feeling. Like going up is easier than like going down.
That makes sense, I guess. So would you say you're an avid traveler?
I want to be. I definitely want to be. I think I want to go. Well, I want to tour, and I want to like. I would say I'm a traveler in the sense as long as I get to do music. So I've been fortunate to go to. The reason why I went to China was to go and sing. So that gave me the opportunity to go and see a whole different country. And because we had CCMAs in Calgary last year, I got to travel to another side of Canada. And I'll be heading to Nashville later on this year. So yeah, I'm hoping music is the reason that I get to be an avid traveler.
Awesome. Well, good luck to you because that sounds like so much fun.
Well, I'm hoping like the cards, like it's in my cards to do it, you know? You got to put out the good music to get those opportunities.
I agree completely. What is your favorite holiday?
My favorite holiday, probably Christmas. The music is good. The presents are nice. Family time is great. Like lots of events, and you get to dress up cute.
Do you have a favorite gift you've gotten over the Christmas time?
It's Christmas time. I honestly, as I get older, I don't ask for gifts really. You know what I got for Christmas? Oh my God. Yeah, I'm blanking. I'm so sorry. I don't
All
remember,
good.
like. But my favorite gift, that I've gotten is my Fender guitar over here. I got that for my 19th birthday.
Ooh, fancy.
So that was also the time in my life where I was a blonde, and I was as blonde as this color. So it was my blonde
Wow.
guitar.
Do you have any favorite bands or artists?
I love Carly Pierce, big Kelsea Ballerini fan. I saw her back in March, and I saw Carly live last year in May. I believe she was in Toronto. And Megan Patrick's pretty cool. She put out a single called She's No Good For Me. That was definitely a bop. And Megan Maroney, her single Tennessee Orange, was also so beautiful. And her song, Hair Salon, I was like, this is so sad, but such great songwriting. And of course, I love Taylor Swift and lots of female artists to look up to. There's so much of good music out there.
I agree completely. Do you have an idol or someone you'd like to channel or resemble your music career or music songs towards?
I definitely have influence from iconic female artists like Taylor Swift. And I definitely started channeling more Carly Pierce with her honesty and her like very intimate performances. But also Kelsea Ballerini, I find like her new stuff really made me want to go down like the pop country kind of vibe where it's like you don't have to be and just be more vulnerable in the music. And I think that's what I'm more attracted to when I'm looking up the artist is like I want to be open and I want a close relationship with anyone that listens to my music. But I also love Taylor because she's just the best. And
Yeah.
I'm really hoping I get to see her on tour.
Awesome. What is one thing that instantly makes your day better, or something that always makes you smile? Something positive in that category of two questions.
Singing always makes anything better. And that's because that's another reason why I said performing is such a safe thing, because when I sing, it's like I just release everything. Like nothing matters. It's just, I don't know, like I guess like people with sports will or who do a sport would understand it. It's like you're just so focused in that, and you're so in your like your own little world. And something that always makes me smile is just memes. I'm a big fan of memes, and I have like multiple friends that I just constantly send memes to, and they're just so funny. Or like funny TikToks. I don't know, I just very sarcastic humor.
Okay. What are you most thankful for?
I'm very thankful for all the opportunities that I've been given, like ever since I started my career, and everyone that chooses to support me and come out to shows, and those who have been there since I have been singing, like before I even started like the artistry. I'm really thankful to be in a very supportive community around me.
Okay, that makes sense. That's a good foundation to have.
And I think I'm always going to be thankful for, no matter like where my career goes, that I get to do this, and I had the opportunity to do this and meet interviewers like yourself, meet other artists, meet other writers, and get to experience this because not a lot of people do.
That's true. Is there anything you wish more people knew about you that they don't know?
Really funny. Just wish they knew that. That sounds like so narcissistic, but a lot of artists have told me that have gotten to know me, they're like, she's just so funny. She'll like say something with a straight face and you don't know if she's kidding. And it's just because I have such dry humor. So I wish people knew that I have a very dry sense of humor. And like I'm always down for like a sarcastic joke or witty banter. That's just like my bread and butter.
Awesome.
But I'm also really nice.
Oh yeah, I can tell, totally. What's one thing you wish you could do that you haven't done yet?
I wish I was playing festivals this year. That's my goal is to be able to play a couple festivals at some point. It's my own fault. I kind of missed the deadlines, but and like the ones that I didn't meet the deadlines for, they already had artists that were chosen for that, and I'm super excited to see those artists play this year, and hoping that next year it's my turn to be on stage.
Oh, I believe in you, if that's anything.
Thank you. Thank you.
And where do you see yourself in 10 years, realistically?
Okay, I'm trying to do the math of how old I will be. Would definitely see myself being a mom, which is like so scary to say because I'm a child. But I will definitely be doing music. I think I will have done a tour by then, like a local or Ontario tour. I'm hoping I would be nominated for CCMA for Female Artist of the Year. And I'm still doing music, and I have a successful music career. But overall, I really think the goal is that I'm really happy and fulfilled no matter what I'm doing.
Awesome. That's great.
Oh, and
Really
I'd be
good
married too. Sorry, I forgot to mention.
answer.
Not just kidding. I'd be married.
Well, that's a good all in all, be married and have kids, having that all together, that's probably the best in your best interest.
Yes, definitely looking out for my best interest.
So we're kind of getting on the ending part here. Is there anyone you'd like to shout out or promote?
Yes, I would love to promote my current single, Red. It's currently out on Spotify, Apple Music, Amazon Music, anywhere that has music attached to it. It's there. It's such a fun song. It's my favorite song that I've released so far. And it's honestly, it came from a joke. I was like, my friends were like, "Why are you always attracted to red flags?" And I was just like, "Red's my favorite color." So the song is built on that like sassy response. It's very lighthearted. And yeah, there's also a music video that features another Canadian country artist, and a bunch of my friends are in it. So if you want to see something visually, that's available on my YouTube, on my YouTube page, which is Kendra Gabrielle Music, and everything else is on everything digital platforms is under Kendra Gabrielle. Sentences are becoming hard to form it right now.
All good, all good. And last but not least, is there anything else you'd like to chat about with me or in general while you have the floor?
No, I think I am good. Thank you so much for reaching out to me to interview and taking the time out of your day. And these were really good questions. A lot of your questions I've never been asked before in an interview. So I really appreciate you asking my personal questions, the questions that stump me.
Awesome. Well, I'm glad I was able to do that. I thank you for your time. And if you're ever in the Edmonton area, which I'm in, let me know, performing otherwise. I'd love to show you around. Love to come to one of your shows in the future. And eventually, when you have merch and the whole shebang, I'd love to own some of that stuff.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Dylan.
I hope you nothing but the best and wish for you to prosper so that I can say I interviewed a celebrity.
Thank you so much, and I wish you luck in your interview journey.
Thank you. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and hopefully, this isn't the end of our conversations. Bye.
We have friendship now. Bye.
Awesome. Bye.